Hello and good evening, and welcome to Tim Ostendorf, baritone innkeeper, discussing his favorite soprano, Joan Sutherland. I started it off, it was very mysterious, wasn't it? Playing the opening to Michaela's big third act aria from Carmen, by Georges Bizet, one of the probably most famous and popular operas in the world, and people get sick of it, but there's a reason it's famous, because the music is very tuneful, and everyone knows it, even if you don't know it, you know what I mean? So anyway, I thought I'd play something a little different from Joan tonight. I'm not going to do the comparison like I've been doing. Instead, this is going to be all Joan. And it's something a little different because it's a role she didn't do that often. She did it quite a lot, you know, early on in her career. It's not the starring role, obviously, because the opera's called Carmen. But when she got signed on, before she made her big splash in Lucia, she got signed on at Covent Garden, and she did things like The First Lady and Magic Flute. She did a couple of those Valkyrie kind of things in the Ring Cycle. She did another role in this opera. She did Frasquita. But then she did finally record the opera in 1963. Thomas Schipper's recording, who died way too young at the age of 47. And that's only 3 years older than I am, so that's very young indeed. It's a great recording with Regina Resnick, Mario Delmonico, and of course Joan Sutherland in the secondary female role of Michaela, Don José's kind of childhood sweetheart. And just I'll give you a little background about the opera. For those of you who have seen this, seen my videos, I try to make it educational as well. And for you big opera people who already know, this is an opera comique, I already know that, why are you telling me that? Well, I, believe it or not, have some family and friends who've been watching some of these videos, and they may not be all about the opera. And so it's something for people to learn. One of the things that I know I've mentioned before that I own an inn in Eaton, New Hampshire called the Inn at Crystal Lake, and I don't think I've talked about the opera dinners we do. We do them once a month, September through May, and I use recordings. We do a fabulous four-course dinner. I use recordings and doing some live singing and with some friends and a pianist and all that. We'll illustrate the story of the opera and things like that. I try to make it educational. So those who are there, like, I already know that. I didn't, you don't have to tell me that. Well, on you, okay? So an opera comique is kind of like the old-fashioned musical theater where the arias and everything are interspersed or separated by spoken dialogue. And a lot of them were after the fact by another composer, maybe even a friend of the composer. They would write recitatives in place of the spoken dialogue. To make it more of a grand opera, so it's sung through. And so this aria has a whole introduction that you just started to hear with a whole kind of recitative before it gets into the aria. It's just a third act. Don José has been seduced by Carmen, and they're off, you know, hiding with the smugglers, and Carmen seduced him, and his life is going down the toilet. And so she is trying to win him back, and so she goes to the smuggler's lair, and she's all scared. And she said, in this little recitative, here I am, the smuggler's hideout. I shall see him again, and without fear, I fulfill the obligation his mother has bound me to. So Don José's mother said to Michaela, hey, go find him and bring him back home, because he's all screwed up. And then she goes into the aria. But first we'll hear the little recitative Joan Sutherland singing Michaela's recitative, not originally written by Georges Bizet, from the opera Carmen in the third act. Oh, and then there's that wonderful French horn introduction. By the way, in many of my videos, I happen to have some sort of drink going. And by the way, it's not always a cocktail. And believe it or not, this is organic pineapple juice with sugar-free Italian lemonade. And to cut the sweetness, a little seltzer. So the fact that I actually act like this without alcohol, hopefully is not too scary. But anyway, it's very, very refreshing, especially in the summer. But it's not summer. It's still February. But it was 52 last week, so it might as well be summer. Anyway, so here's the French horn lead-in to Je dis, her big aria. Je dis que rien ne m'épouvante. I said nothing would frighten me, but of course, alas, she is very frightened. I had to pause right before the next section, which is very dramatic. But anyway, that first bit, I said nothing would frighten me, but alas, alas, that I could look after, I told myself I could look after myself, but no matter how courageous I pretend to be, deep in my heart, I'm dying of fear. So that first line, je dis que rien ne m'épouvante, I said nothing would frighten me. So in my world, in my upper world, we usually just called it je dis. Michael is je dis. And so, you know, the French word for Thursday is je dis. And so during one of my opera dinners that I just talked about when I did Carmen. And by the way, there's not much for me to sing in this except for the Toreador song, which is a bitch to sing, by the way. It's high, it's low, it kind of sits in the passaggio, but it's a very funky, it's not a very rewarding piece. Everyone loves it, everyone knows it. Yeah, whatever. But it's a terrible, it's a bear to sing, so whatever. In my world, when I was a student, we would jokingly call this Michaela's Thursday aria. And so I'm telling this story at my opera dinner, and this woman who's like staring at me like, oh, I don't get it. What do you mean? I'm like, you know, Thursday, jeudi, and like the start, you know, jeudi. And she's like, well, it's pronounced completely differently. The accent's different. And I'm like, I get it. Jeudi and jeudi, okay? But it's a joke. Get over it, lady. I'm supposed to be having fun here, okay? Okay, big dramatic next section. Okay, and alone in this wild place, all alone, I'm afraid. But I'm wrong to be afraid. You will give me courage, she says, oh Lord, Seigneur, you will protect me. And so you'll hear that in the music, and it's very exciting. She goes up to this high B natural, and it's thrilling and chilling and wonderful. She holds it. There is a fermata, but boy, does she hold it. It is great. Okay, here we go. That's just a B natural. There's a B coming up that I'm talking about. That, even though that was spectacular, there's even a better one, okay? Sorry, I'm looking at the score. There is no fermata, but she does definitely hold it after the orchestra cuts out, which I absolutely love. So let's see if I can cue that up a little again, just to hear that again. Oh, shoot. I did it wrong. Well, we'll figure it out. But anyway, oh, shoot. Boy, this is the problem. You know, you get the little thing. See if I can cue it up. Boy, I'm going to run out of time. Then I'm going to be all pissed off. All right. We'll get this. We'll get it. Almost there. Oh, there it was. Okay, so now I know where to go. I'll back it up a little. Sorry about that. So it's just something a little different from Joan. Something, you know, afterwards she did a lot more of the color tour stuff. And so it's just wonderful to hear her doing something a little out of kind of what most people would think of out of her Fach, out of her normal vocal stuff. But I think it's lovely. It's one of my absolute favorite recordings of that aria, and actually one of my favorites of Joan's in general, just because it's a little different. I think you can get most of her French words and keep it right here, French. So I don't know what's going to happen next and when my next one will be, but I hope you enjoyed something a little different tonight. Tim Ostendorf, innkeeper baritone, lover of all things Joan Sutherland. Have a good night, and we will see you soon. Au revoir.